हेलो, गुड इवनिंग माय बेबीज, गुड इवनिंग ममाज एंड पापाज। आई होप यू गाइज आर डूइंग वेल। यस, लेट्स जस्ट वेट फॉर वन मोर मिनट फॉर आर फ्रेंड्स टू ज्वाइन इन। एंड व्हाइल दे ज्वाइन इन, कीप राइटिंग योर नेम्स डाउन देयर, कीप राइटिंग योर कमेंट्स। यस, एंड लाइक आई सेड लास्ट टाइम, आई एम गोना रीड ऑल ऑफ देम। एंड व्हाइल आर फ्रेंड्स आर ज्वाइनिंग इन, आई अपर्णा चौधरी वुड लाइक टू वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ माइंडसीट प्री स्कूल एंड डे केयर। यस, वी आर बैक अगेन, येट अनादर सैटरडे एंड येट अनादर फन स्टोरी टाइम सेशन। नाउ वी बीन डूइंग अ लॉट ऑफ स्टोरीज ओवर द पास्ट फ्यू वीक्स। वी हैव डन स्टोरीज फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। सो वेदर इट इज इची बेयर और वेदर इट इज द डे क्रियॉन्स डिसाइडेड टू क्विट, वी बीन डूइंग अ होल लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट स्टोरीज। एंड व्हाइल वी वर डूइंग दीज स्टोरीज दिस वीक, वी थॉट Why not do a story written by an Indian author? So today's story is a very, very special story. It is one of my favorites, and I know I can vouch that it is one of our favorites at Mindseed. Our children love it. Our teachers love narrating this story. Yes, and this character is very, very special. I really, really love him. And he's been waiting, eagerly waiting to meet all of you. Do you want to meet him? Yes. Should we call him? Come on. Everybody close your eyes because he doesn't come just like that. He has a special entry. So come on, everybody close your eyes, close your eyes, close your eyes, close your eyes. Yes, who is it? Ta-da, ladies and gentlemen. Presenting Gajapati Kulapati. Can we say hi? Hi, Gajapati Kulapati. Isn't he adorable? Yes, the name of the story is Gajapati Kulapati and it is written by Ashok Rajagopalan. Now, he is a very, very special elephant. He lived in a village. Now, before we start with the story, should we say hello to him and observe how he looks? Yes, I mean, look at his tiny two eyes. Now, Gajapati Kulapati was a big elephant. Can you see how big he is? He's quite big. He's bigger than me, actually. It's very difficult to hold him right now. Yes, very, very difficult, but I am. Yes, and he has a long trunk. A long nose, and he has lovely two ears, and he's gray in color. Yes, and these are his teeth. They are known as tusk. What are they known as? Tusk. Yes. Now Gajapati Kulapati, he lived in a village, and all the people in the village just loved him. They all loved him because he was a big elephant. But he was also a gentle elephant. He would give all the kids a ride on his back. He would help out in case if somebody was in need. And so on and so forth. So everybody loved him. Yes? Now one day, while he was walking around the village, he was taking a walk. He was strolling around the village. And how does an elephant walk? They actually kind of sway. So come on, everybody. Let's sway with him. He goes this way and that way. Come on, Gajapati Kulapati. Goes this way and that way. He just sways. He was happily walking with a lovely smile on his face. And while he was walking, tip, tip, tip. And Gajapati Kulapati looked at the sky. And he suddenly realized, what is falling from the sky, from the clouds? Yes, it was rainy season and it had started dripping. Yes, there was a tiny drizzle and we can actually make the rain. Do you want to make some rain? We actually can't make rain. We can make the sound of the rain. So come on, let's do that. Take your palm, take a finger and we're going to start. Come on. Tiny droplets of water. Now it started drizzling. And slowly and slowly, the raindrops, they started increasing. The rain started increasing. And it started pouring. And poor Gajapati Kulapati, he got all wet. He was drenched. And he was like, what do I do? And when you get wet, what happens? What normally happens when you get wet? Yes, we catch a cold, right? We catch a cold and we start sneezing. And that's what happened with poor Gajapati Kulapati. Now, small noses, just like mine and yours, get small cold. But big noses get big cold. And Gajapati Kulapati got a big cold. And he was trying to sniff. He was trying to smell things he couldn't. He was trying to breathe with his blocked nose. Come on, everybody, try to breathe like him. He was trying very hard, but he just couldn't. And while he was doing that, his friend walked in. Who was this? Yes. It was the banana seller. Now, Gajapati Kulapati loved eating bananas. He loved them. And the banana seller came to Gajapati Kulapati just like he would every morning. He went to him and said, Gajapati Kulapati, do you want to eat some bananas? And he showed him bananas. And as soon as he did that, Gajapati Kulapati was very happy. He was like, he wanted to eat the bananas. And you and I would eat one banana or two banana. But we are talking about the great Gajapati Kulapati. And he wanted to have all the bananas. And so he went to open his mouth to say yes. And instead of yes, what happened? Should I tell you what happened? He went, and what happened? Yes, the banana seller, he almost shook. And all the bananas from his hands flew right down there. And right there, the postman uncle was walking. And the bananas fell on the postman uncle's head. Dhadam! And postman uncle looked at the sky and said, what? Bananas are falling out of the sky? I had heard and I had seen for my own two eyes ki barish hoti hai, rain comes down. Maybe, you know, flower petals here and there. But bananas? And he was still shaking. And why he was shaking? Because of all those bananas that, you know, fell, and he slipped on a banana and he fell right on a cow who was behind him, and he was like, dhadam! And the cow was scared and she ran. She was like, amma, amma, and she ran away from there. And while all this was happening, poor Gajapati Kulapati was like, he was sad. He didn't like to hurt his friends. He just didn't like to hurt his friends. And when you hurt your friends or anyone, what do we say when we hurt our friends or our family members or anyone for that matter? We should say sorry, right? And Gajapati Kulapati was a pavam elephant. He was an innocent, very nice elephant. And he wanted to say sorry too. And so he opened his mouth to say sorry. But instead of sorry, what came out? Tell me. Yes, you guessed it right. Come on, chalo. Everybody, let's sneeze with Gajapati Kulapati. And it has to be a loudest sneeze. Come on, go. 1, 2, 3, go. And everybody shook because of that. Achoo. And the banana seller, he was scared. He ran as fast as he could. And the postman ran as fast as he could. And the cow ran as fast as she could. She was like, Amma. Now, while all this was happening, poor Gajapati Kulapati, he felt very, very sad. He was feeling very sad. He was like, I hurt my friends. I don't want to see anyone. So he went, he swayed, sadly this time, not happily. And he went and he hid behind a wall. Yes. You know why he hid behind a wall? Because he didn't have a house. So he went and hid behind a wall. He went and sat down. We usually do that, right? When we feel sad, we want to just go and sit. We don't want anyone to disturb us. And he also didn't want to. But he didn't want to because he didn't want to hurt anyone. And when this happened, all these villagers started talking about it. They started talking about Gajapati Kulapati getting cold. So the banana seller, he went up to the tailor and he told the tailor this. The news of Gajapati Kulapati getting cold had spread like fire all around the village. Yes. And the banana seller, he went and told the tailor, Hello, bhaiya, did you listen? Aapne suna? Haan, did you hear? Gajapati Kulapati has got a cold. Now, as soon as the tailor heard that, he ran. He ran to the milkman and said, Bhaiya, suna, did you hear? Gajapati Kulapati has got cold. The milkman also felt very sad. And while he was walking, he met the flower seller. And he met her and he said, Flower seller, Didi, aapne suna, did you hear? Poor Gajapati Kulapati has got a cold. The flower seller was also very, very sad. She was walking by with her flowers to be sold. And she met, postman uncle. And she looked at him and said, Did you hear? Gajapati Kulapati has got a cold. Ayyo paavam, poor elephant. And postman uncle was like, What do you think he reacted like? He too had fallen thanks to Gajapati Kulapati's sneeze. So he was like, I know, don't tell me. My God, what do we do now? How do we help Gajapati Kulapati? All the villagers were very, very worried for him. The day came to an end. Yes, the sun set. It was night time. Everybody was trying to figure out what to do to help him. Now it was night time and everyone went to bed. While everyone was sleeping, Gajapati Kulapati couldn't sleep. And you know why? Because he had a blocked nose. He had a cold. He couldn't breathe properly and he was sad. So you're like... Until then, there was a sound. Was it a dog? And it got louder. Was it a lion? And it got louder. And the villagers got up and they were like, Oh my God, is the sky falling? But who was it? It was none other than Gajapati Kulapati. And that's when, what happened? Yes, there was a sneeze coming up. So let's sneeze. It has to be the biggest, loudest sneeze ever. Okay, so come on, let's sneeze with him. 1, 2, 3. Gajapati went, And it was such a loud sneeze that he himself was shaken by that sneeze. And all the villagers also got up. They were like, what happened? What happened? And they were all scared. We get scared, right? When there's a sudden loud noise. They all looked here and there. And suddenly they realized, it is Gajapati Kulapati. He must have sneezed. So they all went back to bed. They said, okay, you know what? Let's get up in the morning and let's see what to do with Gajapati Kulapati. But because of that sneeze, suddenly Gajapati Kulapati realized his nose was open, his trunk had opened. He could actually breathe again. He was like, he went around, he sniffed, he saw some flowers and he sniffed there and he was like, oh, I can smell again. Oh wow, he was very happy, he was cheerful. And that is the time when he decided, okay, now I can go to bed. I can say sorry to everyone tomorrow morning and I'm going to go off to bed now. And so Gajapati Kulapati, he went and he slept. Next day morning, everybody got up. And you know, everybody was worried about Gajapati Kulapati, right? So everyone went to check on him. The banana seller went, the postman uncle went, they all went to check on him. And when they went to check on him, they were so happy. Because what did they see? They saw Gajapati Kulapati swaying happily, just like he always did. Come on, everybody sway with Gajapati Kulapati. He went this way and that way. This way and that way. This way and that way. Look how happy he is right now. He's so, so happy. And the banana seller looked at him and he said, oh, Gajapati Kulapati, you are fine again. Yes, my friend. And he went and hugged him. He gave him a big hug. He was very happy for him. Yes. And the postman uncle also came and he looked at him and he shook his trunk. And he said, wow, Gajapati Kulapati, you're all fine. I'm so happy for you. Just like that. Tailor uncle, flower seller, all the children in the village, they all came and gave him a big hug and they patted him and they were like, yes, finally Gajapati Kulapati is all fine. While everybody was happy, someone walked in. Who was it? Yes, it was an old wise grandmother of the village. Now, grandmothers are very, very smart. So she came and she said, Gajapati Kulapati, let me check you, beta. And she went and checked. Does he have fever? Now is he going to sneeze? And when she checked, she said, you look all fine to me, Raja. Okay, I'm happy for you, Gajapati Kulapati. But this cannot be the solution. We need to do something for him. She was right. So what did she do? She went and called all the villagers. She said, postman, milkman, all the children in the village, come here. And when everybody came, she said, listen, we don't want our poor Gajapati Kulapati to fall sick again. So we'll have to make a house for him, okay? And I will need everybody to work together. When everybody works together, the work is faster. Come on, everybody, chalo kaam pe lago, chalo ghar banate hain. And all the villagers heard what she said. They all got to work. They all started making a house for Gajapati Kulapati. And soon, when so many hands put together, the work was faster. And Gajapati Kulapati was so happy. He was like, wow, I'm going to get a new house. And they made a big house with long sticks and hay. And they told him, come on, let's go, Gajapati Kulapati. And grandmother came and she checked, she examined the house. And she said, now this house is very, very strong. And our Gajapati Kulapati can stay inside. He can stay in and he can stay safe. Okay, my pavam elephant. Don't come out if it rains, okay? Stay safe, stay inside. And she was right. She told all the villagers, whenever there's any danger, you should stay inside your house. Yes? You should stay inside your house. Stay in Stay safe is what she told Gajapati Kulapati and she told all the villagers. And after that, Gajapati Kulapati never got wet. He was all fine in his house. And villagers often heard achoo. And they heard achoo. And achoo. And achoo. But never ever did they hear. Let's one last time sneeze with him. Come on, one big loud sneeze. Mamas and papas, you are also going to do it. Come on, let's do it. Yes. All right. I hope you liked this story. Like I said, it's one of my favorite stories. It has so many fun things, and at the same time it also tells us to take care of ourselves. So like I said, it's rainy season now. It started raining already. So even when you go out, don't forget to carry umbrellas. And as far as possible, stay in and stay safe. Alright? Should we sing a song for Gajapati Kulapati? I've been saying pavam pavam, right? I heard this word from a friend of mine and I really liked it. Really liked it. And it totally suits him. Pavam is innocent, you know. Poor little. Chona Ganpati. Chona elephant. Sorry. Yes, that's what it basically means. Alright? And he's cute, isn't he? He looks like a poor little nice elephant who doesn't want to hurt anyone. Yes? So should we sing a song for him? I'm going to sing the song and you are going to sing after me. Alright? Ready? Okay? One, two, three. Let's go. Gaju the elephant goes this way and that. Gaju the elephant goes this way and that. He's so very big. He's always glad. He's so very big. He's always glad. He sways his trunk from left to right. He sways his trunk from left to right. He takes us for a jolly ride. He takes us for a jolly ride. Yes. Come on, let's say bye Gajapati Kulapati. Bye sweetheart. We'll see you soon. Come on. He wants to say bye to all of you. Okay. He's saying bye to you and you and you. Bye mama papas. Bye. Okay, he's gone. So yes, yet another weekend, yet another story. We really hope you liked this one. Definitely don't forget to give your suggestions, your comments in the comment section. I'll be waiting and I'll read each one of them. Again, stay in, stay safe. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Mindseed Preschool, and our Facebook page, which is Mindseed Preschool again. And we will meet you soon next week. Until then, tata, take care. Love all my babies. Yes, I'll be seeing you guys soon. Bye. See you.